when we make subtle shifts to our mindset, to what we put into our bodies, towards our art making, it doesn't matter what it is. When we make tiny little shifts towards whatever it is we want to change, we can make such a big impact in the long run. Small changes that we can make now can impact where we are in 5 years' time. It's mind-blowing. This is what I want to share in today's episode. Because as I look back over time and I realise when I wanted to set up United ArtSpace years ago and I had babies and I had other work that I was doing to bring money in, and it felt like an impossible task to ever get United ArtSpace off the ground. I remember crying my eyes out because I had this vision of setting up United ArtSpace, but I could just never do it because I always felt like there was always a demand on my life and always things in the way, and I was exhausted, and it was like there was just no time to ever get this off the ground. And I remember back then, I don't know what the catalyst was, but I remember starting with the change of carving out 1 hour a week. It was major. And at that time, it felt like I was getting nowhere. Like, with 1 hour a week, what am I going to do in that hour? But because I only had 1 hour a week, I worked really smart in that hour. And I remember when I first started, I wanted to set an online platform. I had no clue how to set a website up. I had no clue how to do anything. And in that hour, I got really clear on learning and how to use that hour to learn what I wanted to do. And then it turned into 2 hours and 4 hours and so on. And so it got me really thinking this week about the little changes that I want to make in my life right now that I know will impact where I am in 5 years' time. And it's quite a profound thought, really, because sometimes when we're taking small actions now, we don't actually realize the impact it is really having on our lives. And I want to share this because sometimes we disregard the small things and are like, what's the point in just spending an hour on this? Or what's the point in doing this? It just seems so insignificant because the picture in our head that we want is so much bigger. And it feels so hard to get there sometimes. So we're trying to aim for the mountain overnight, but we realize that we've just got to start really, really small and we will get to the mountain. It's just going to take time. So I want to encourage you to think about something in your life that either, one, you want to just let go of. Maybe there's something in your life that just is not serving you anymore. It might be a thought, a behavior, you maybe feel that you're stagnant recently. There might be something that, for example, food for me, I'm realizing that my body is very triggered by different foods at the moment. And so I know that I've got to let go of some of the foods that I love putting into my body because they're not helping my body. And so what I'm doing is Monday to Friday, being very mindful of what goes in. And I'm letting go of that stuff. I know it's hard, but it's going to help me. So I'm making small little shifts, introducing small little steps. Another one was, I remember when I wanted to make art and I was never making it because I was busy with United ArtSpace. And I then made that small shift again. But for a long time, I was trying to jump into, right, one day a week I'll make art. And it was just too much. It was too much to run United ArtSpace and do that and have the children at the same time. And so then I shortened it down. And to this day, I still have the 2 hours that I carved out years ago. On a Friday with my members, every Friday, I dedicate that time to making art. That's my time to be connected to my art practice. And now I've taken it that step further. And I now go to the pottery with Sharon at Sharon's place every Friday. And it's extended now because I have a little bit of time before and a little bit of time after. And so again, that was a small step. And now every Friday, I make sure that I go to the pottery. So I'm making sure that I'm getting out of this dining room, which I spend my life in, and I'm getting out into the pottery. Small steps, because another thing that I've noticed recently is that I work a lot at home. I don't see anybody. You know, I work, there's many, many pros to working from home, but there's many, many downsides. And the fact is you don't see anyone. You're literally just in your dining room all day long, chugging away. And then I go and pick the children up and I'm like, you know, this is crazy. And so one thing that I really noticed in myself was I need to get out. I actually need to get out. And so Fridays now, I am going to the pottery and making myself go out. Small little steps that will end up becoming bigger, I know for a fact. Sometimes the question to ask yourself is, there's something that I want to do that I'm actually not doing. So it can be something that you want to let go of. Is something not serving you anymore? It might be a limiting belief. It might be that you've got stuck in a rut. You might be watching the same thing over and over and realize this is a waste of time. Or there might be a direction that you want to head towards, a direction of I want this, but it feels so far out of reach, or it feels so, you know, unachievable. And what's the smallest change that you can make today towards getting to that point? It might be the way you think. I like to think of be, do, have. What do I need to do? Who do I need to be? What do I need to have to get a bit closer? And it might be carving out just 15 minutes a week to work towards your art, or to take some time out because you feel like you've been pushing it. What's the one small change that you can make today that might have a big impact on your life 5 years from now? It could be this very moment that you decide to do something that's just going to change your whole future with one small step. Have a great week, my friends, and I'll see you again next week. Take care. Bye-bye.